it's Sarah. Today I'm going to be doing my top 5 books that I didn't think I was gonna like, but loved. So, Top 5 Wednesdays was created by Ginger Reads Lainey, and I'm going to leave all the information in the below bar if you're interested in doing this thing, because it's really, really fun. So these aren't really in any sort of order, I've just selected at random, and this was actually really difficult for me just because I normally don't read books that I don't think I'm gonna like. If I'm investing time into a book, I'm gonna kind of make sure it somewhat lines up to what I'm interested in and all that fun stuff. So this was a little tricky, but I got it. Don't worry. Number 1 was Perfume by Patrick Susskind. This book was given to me by my nanny while I was in Mexico with my family. My aunt and my nanny had both read it and they were ranting and raving about how amazing it was. And generally, we don't really have the same sort of interest in books, but I had read all of the, I think, 6 books that I had brought on the vacation. This is before I had my Kobo. Anyway, I read it, and oh my god, this book is phenomenal. This book is about a guy named Grenouille. Grenouille lives in 18th century France, and he has this crazy good sense of smell. This story is essentially just like an inner monologue of Grenouille, and oh my goodness, this book is phenomenal. It was actually translated, I think, from German, I want to say, and so I wouldn't even have guessed that this was a translation until I had looked it up, and yeah, it's just the story of this guy and he murders people, but he's the narrator, but he's terrible, but just the writing style is just, oh, it's amazing. It's so good. So yeah, Perfume is my number 5. Coming up in number 4 is Monkey Beach by Eden Robinson. This book was for a creative writing class, I believe, and it is a local book. It is set in a small town called Kitimat, which is in British Columbia, which is in Canada, which is where I live in British Columbia. This story is essentially about a young native girl named Lisa and her brother Johnny goes missing at sea while he's out fishing, and essentially this story is just like a blend of Native American spirituality, blending lines between what's real and what's not, and oh, this is like a pretty much a Canadian contemporary kind of thing, and it is really, really good. I think the reason I didn't think I was gonna like it was 1, because it was contemporary, and 2, because it was assigned reading, and I'll read anything, but if you tell me I have to read it, then it's just like, I don't want to read it. But yeah, so I could go on about this book, but this is like a phenomenal Canadian book. It is great. Go read it, please, especially if you're a Canadian reader. This book is awesome. Coming in at number 3, we have Stolen by Lucy Christopher. I wasn't really like not thinking I was gonna like it, but I was kind of doubting it going into it. I was just in the mood for something contemporary, and so I kind of wandered to my local bookstore and went to the new adult section, and they had this there. I was like, once again, it's a contemporary book. I wasn't sure if I was gonna like it, if I was gonna be wasting my money on this book, but oh my goodness, this book was amazing. This book is about a girl named Gemma, and Gemma is kidnapped while her family is on vacation from the Bangkok airport to the Australian outback by a boy named Ty. And Ty is, he's the kidnapper, but at the same time, Gemma's going through a whole lot of kind of Stockholm syndrome, doubting herself. She goes from hating Ty to being like, hey, he's maybe not so bad. And it's just kind of the inner struggle of Gemma dealing with the situation, and I think it's just an amazing book dealing with Stockholm syndrome and kidnapping, and yeah, I thought this was really great, and it's just like paints such an amazing picture of the Australian outback, which I think is quite pretty. I mean, beside the whole deserty death trap thing. But yeah, so wasn't sure if I was gonna like it. I really liked it, so yay, I didn't waste my money. So for number 2, we have The Giver by Lovis Lowry. I never had to read this book for school, I know a lot of people do, and every time I saw like the old cover with the old man, the giver, on the front, I kind of associated the book with like Hatchet or just like a really boyish kind of book, so I never read it until about a month ago, and I really thought I wasn't gonna like it, but then once everybody started talking about it, I was like, hey, maybe I should read it, and I'm so glad that I did. The Giver is essentially a really early dystopian book that helped pave the way for all the dystopian books that we know and love today. And it's about a boy named Jonas who lives in a society where everybody gets assigned a job, and his job is to be trained by this man called the Giver. He's very mysterious, and it's just when the Giver shares experiences and history and all that good stuff with Jonas, and this book was so fast-paced and so good, and I can't believe that I didn't read this in like elementary school because it's really, really good. So yes, The Giver. And lastly, for number one, I have Obsidian by Jennifer L. Armentrout. And this book, oh my god, this book, you guys. I wasn't sure if I was gonna like it. I had heard so many mixed things about this book, and so I just kind of saw it in a thrift store for like a dollar. I was like, hey, I'll buy that. And so I was like, hey, this is the perfect time to try this book. And this book, I really, really liked. This is never going to be like a great literary classic, but oh my god, did I have a great time reading this book. This is just kind of like popcorn at a movie theater. It's just like a guilty pleasure. This book is just completely an indulgent treat. It's a teen paranormal romance that involves aliens. If you haven't read this book, and if you enjoy paranormal romance books, I would recommend, because I really liked it. And I know it's not everybody's cup of tea, but for me, it was good. So yeah, I didn't think I was gonna really like it, just because everyone was saying how like fluffy and silly and ridiculous it was. But that just worked fine for me because it's flippin' fantastic. But yes, so that is my top 5 Wednesday, top 5 books that I didn't think I was going to like, but then ended up liking anyway. Thank you for watching my video, and I will see you guys later.